Making a web app work offline or have amazing performance on slow networks used to be extremely hard, but service workers changed that. I've asked Jake Archibald to explain service workers for us. Jake, take it away.
A service worker is a JavaScript Realm execution context in an environment settings object with its own event loop and node document dependency. Unlike similar contexts such as shared workers, this context lifecycle is dictated by lifecycle and functional extendable events and their associated array of extended lifecycle promises, although the user agent may apply a grace period to avoid startup shutdown overhead between events.
Okay, that made no sense. Let's try this from a different angle. A service worker is a JavaScript file that is run by your browser in the background, separate from your web page, and handles events fired either by the browser or your web page. Since it's run in the background, it doesn't need the web page to be open, and it doesn't show any markup. Where it really shines is the events that it can listen for. One of the most exciting is the ability to handle fetch events, intercepting and responding to network requests. This puts the service worker virtually between the network and the browser, allowing the service worker to provide content even when offline. Because the service worker can listen for events even when the page isn't open, they can respond to push messages sent from the server to the browser. Imagine a chat web client that lets you know you've got a new unread message. This simply wasn't possible before. In the future, service workers will support other things like periodic sync, geofencing, and more. In the past, you could have tried using app cache to try and make an app work offline, but it was a pain. There were too many gotchas, and it didn't have the power or flexibility that service workers brings.